Novelist John Updike died today of lung cancer. In his long career, he was frequently on the bestseller list and won just about every literary prize there is.
These are old books now.
John Updike had a knack for raising some profound issues in some pretty unusual settings.
Of course, we make mistakes, they call it evil. When God makes mistakes, they call it nature.
Most people will remember The Witches of Eastwick. In that famous novel turned hit movie, the devil himself wakes up a sleepy New England town.
He took inward notes on the bright, quick impressions.
But in his prolific career, Updike was generally more inclined to tackle lesser evils. Sex, divorce, and adultery, the issues lying just below the surface in every suburb in America, including his hometown of Shillington, a suburb of Reading, Pennsylvania.
Beyond making a record of contemporary life, which is what you inevitably do, he was trying to make beautiful books.
You're happy with these colors.
John Updike once said his goal was to write a book a year.
I thought I signed all these already.
Since the 1950s, more than 50 novels and several volumes of poetry and essays have been published. His acclaimed second novel, Rabbit Run, has been published in 29 countries and sold millions of copies worldwide. The book's sequels, Rabbit Is Rich and Rabbit at Rest, won him 2 Pulitzer Prizes in the fiction category.
Yeah. Cousin Lee.
Yeah.
One of America's most accomplished authors, inspiration came frequently to Updike, but he said writing daily wasn't easy. As he told Time magazine in 1982, you'd rather do almost anything than tackle that empty page, because what you do on the page is you. John Updike was 76.